Hi everyone, it's been quite some time since I posted my video about getting an Android certification from Google. I frequently get questions around how to become an Android developer or how to get certified. So this video is about an example path you can follow for the next few months to go from a beginner to an intermediate Android app developer, which is the target level you need to be at to clear the exam. The exam is currently paused as Google is updating the exam syllabus, but this is a good time to start so that you feel comfortable enough in the future. But before creating a roadmap, let's talk about the prerequisites. Some programming experience would be very helpful for you to begin. If you have decent knowledge in any of the compiled languages like C++ or Java, that's a great start. But even if you come from a web development background, it will still help. The goal here is to go from a beginner to a good enough entry-level experience in the fastest way possible. We will be targeting Kotlin as the preferred language to develop Android apps. The core elements comprising an Android application include building the user interface, implementing system APIs and SDKs like the notification API, storage, camera, alarms, etc. Then there comes the internet connectivity, networking and API calls. And on the side, there's testing and debugging, which are crucial to building an Android application. This video lays out all the resources you will need throughout the journey. All of these are completely free and one of the best out there. But do note that most of them will be written format articles because reading documentations is the best way to learn. Video tutorials will just spoon feed you and not make you very efficient. Let's begin with the Android Developers course website. This is the official website by Google for Android development tutorials and courses, which are launched by Google employees. For beginners, start with Android Basics in Kotlin course, which is based on XML. Even though Compose is becoming the modern standard and will be required in the future exam, knowledge of XML views still plays a crucial role because you will find that most of the tutorials on the internet are based on XML as Compose is still newer. During this course, you will get exercises to make sample apps and fix existing code in given samples. Make sure to practice them thoroughly. You can also find some of the solutions at my GitHub profile. This course can take you anywhere from 2 to 4 months based on the pace you cover it at. Take your time to practice what's being taught and you will very easily understand how Android apps basically work. After doing this course based on XML, you can skim through the Compose course to understand the newer toolkits. Compose is much easier than Vue because it enables you to implement UI through Kotlin code itself, which avoids the need for managing XML files separately. Since you will have done the XML based course, this course will be very easy for you to skim. Once done with the course, I will recommend you to do this short course on Kotlin coroutines, which will aid your understanding of multitasking approaches in Android. With this 4 months of practice, when you refer the exam's study guide, you will find that you have already covered and understand almost everything so far. Make sure to build practice apps to enhance your learnings. From the exam's point of view, the most important topics you need to be well versed are, first is implementing UI. You need to understand the commonly used layouts and elements and how to implement them. Constraint layout is very important and recycler view is a must to know, and view pager will be beneficial. You need to be able to implement MVVM architecture, activities and fragments that deal with view models, which then deal with repository and data access objects for the room DB. You need to know how notifications and work manager work. You need to be able to schedule tasks with Work Manager and display notification from within those tasks. Then you need to know how room database and pagination work together. The exam will definitely test you on your knowledge of room database and pagination with the Paging3 library. I have written this comprehensive article on pagination in Android room database using the Paging3 library. All the links mentioned in this video are there in the description box below. So make sure to use these resources to the fullest to aid your learning journey. Since debugging is mostly about printing statements and resolving simple bugs, but for testing, you need to be able to write UI and unit tests using Espresso library. All of this is covered in the Android Basics in Kotlin course that I mentioned to you. For further resources, if you want to learn from video tutorials, I would recommend any of the famous YouTubers in the Android space like Philip, Stephen, or Florian. All of these have amazing Android content, but the videos will make a lot more sense when you do the beginner's course first. To conclude, the biggest takeaway here would be to practice as much as you can. There's a lot of free content available to study as and when you want, but it all boils down to how much you practice yourself without the help of tutorials. That is what is going to improve your skills really. When I was learning, I built this open source Quartz app and implemented everything here, and it managed to evolve from a basic Quartz viewing app to a lot more. I recommend the same for you. Pick a basic idea for an app and try to implement everything you learn to improve that app. Also, open source it to help others too. At the end, you will feel very confident and proud of doing that. I hope this study pattern helps you reach a respectable level in Android app development the fastest way possible. If you ever need any help or need to just stay connected, do join our Discord server at discord.genixblog.com. All the best and see you very soon.